David! Useless! Damn innocent!
My name is Alberto Figueroa. I am the director slash writer for the thesis film that was done this month, Slicker. First day, I'm not gonna lie, I was pretty excited. You know, I was like, oh man, this is actually coming to life. We get to the location, we set up everything. Then the trucks come in, you know, they start trying to figure out where they're gonna put the, you know, the Jenny and the wiring and the lighting and all that stuff. We were supposed to get our first shot at 9 o'clock, and we didn't start till like almost 10:30. You know, we're already an hour and a half behind. So on Tuesday, we were able to make up those shots and a little more. So Tuesday was better. Everybody knew what they had to do and pick up the pace. And then on Wednesday, we were like in the backwoods. A lot of power, a lot of five wire and lunch boxes, had to go into the woods or whatnot, and it was supposed to rain that day, but thank God it did not rain that day, so it was good. The final day, it rained, and at that location, when it rains, it looks like a river. So, you know, that was the final killing scene in the backwoods, and it was flooded, it was muddy, there's no way we can put power or anything on there. And I was just walking around like, man, how... Like, I didn't know what to do. I was like, man, this is the ending of the film. So I literally sat outside and I was walking around just looking. And one of my instructors came and he asked me, well, what are you going to do? And I was like, I don't know. He's like, why don't you just change the ending? So I literally, like, on the fly, made up a whole new ending. So everything we shot on that last day was not even in the script. So I made up a new ending on the fly, and the crazy thing is I actually liked the new ending I made on the fly, so it actually turned out pretty well. Everybody has a job to do and they have to pull their own weight, so like when it came to like the DP and his camera team had to make like the camera plots, and you know, as a director, you kind of want to not overstep people, but you do want to be involved in like what the DP is doing, like in camera plotting or light plotting and electric plotting, because you know it is your vision as a director, so it's their job to bring your vision to life. What I learned during that process is it's very important to have like be supportive of every department and try to maintain a close relationship, especially with your producer. It will get stressful. People are gonna argue. People are gonna disagree with each other. There'll be little fights here and there, but from my experience, when it came to like game time, you know, everybody actually did their part, and we all, like, every night we went home pretty satisfied, and on that last day we were all pretty proud of what we did. The most difficult thing, that was the part where he attacks him with the rock, and we had a special effect of the blood gushing out of the guy's head. It would gush out, and it, you know, that takes some time to prep and stuff. I think we should have done that first. That way we can do multiple takes of that. But we did that last, so it felt rushed. But I mean, it still looked good. It was a good experience. I think for everybody, it was a learning experience for everybody. You know, everybody actually learned what it was like to be I learned what it was like to be a director, the DP. You know, if you want to be a DP, a lot of work is on the DP. You know, because when it comes to camera, where the camera's going, what kind of lens you're using. What kind of aspect ratio are you going to use? What kind of lighting do you want? And you know, the gaffer is the lighting guy, but the DP is the one that tells him how he wants it to look. And if you're a gaffer or a grip, you know, for our project, it was outside, so we needed a lot of things. So it was, you know, you're going to get dirty and sweaty and whatnot. One thing I learned is, I think everybody goes through this. Everybody's gonna go through it. As a director, writer for a film, not everybody's gonna like it. You know, somebody's always gonna claim that they can do it better than you. Somebody's gonna say, "Oh, your script sucks." I'm a very positive person, so I've heard those things. But I don't really care. You know, it was stuff like that shouldn't bother you and stop you from what you're doing. A lot of us are like first-time filmmakers, so you know, you're gonna make mistakes, but you're gonna learn from them. And as you make more things, you're gonna get better. You know, it's obvious. If you're willing to let go of your ego and learn, I would love to do it again.